So FLEWED out came about one day. I was doing a drop for one of my shows and I was tired. I just had finished the show and I was in the car doing the drop and I was trying to say blown out, but it came out as FLEWED. I was like, I'm not fixing it. Like, I'm tired. I done said this like 10 times. It's coming out wrong. Put it out. They know what I meant. So now that it's actually a phrase, when a guy sit for you, like, he fly you out, take you shopping, make them piece of tea, and send you back home.
If that's all you're looking for, then don't fly me out.
But that's what I'm saying. It's based on the conversation they had before that. So they know if you're getting to that point where, okay, I want to see you, I'm going to fly you out. Girl, you know you're going to end up probably having to get
it depends, though. Because people that, people that are flying you out, I would assume they have a certain financial status. And that's the reason that people that don't have that financial status be trying to do this fly out thing and getting upset. That's the problem.
Hello. Welcome to Reactions and Reviews. I'm your humble host, Eze. Thank you, and I hope you enjoy the show. Ladies and gentlemen, we are living in the era of women's liberation, where a woman can do no wrong. Whatever she does, no one can question her. No one can call her out. No one can critique her. She's free to do as she please, have as many body counts as she wants. An era where even the average woman can get flued out all over the world for the weekend in exchange for, you know, a roll in the hay. Now, if you go to IG, Twitter, Facebook, getting flued out is the new trend. A lot of women want to get flued out. A guy comes in your DM, drops you a message, a week later, he flies you out, blows your back out, send you back home, right? And a lot of sisters love that. They love getting flued out, changing in their hotel rooms, taking pictures for the gram, or, you know, taking videos for the gram. They can show other women how life is good. And we all know, no matter how good something is, that's always the opposite. That's nature. At some point, it gets bad.
Okay, so I deadass think he's like joking about me touching these dogs. So what do I do because I'm drunk? Fucking touch him. Y'all, so he loses it. Like, he fucking loses it. And he starts going off on me in Bible verses. Like, I have never, even to this day, been cussed out in biblical format, but I mean, he did a really good job. He was calling me Jezebel. He was reciting verses that I know were verses, but he was just on one. And now, mind you, my phone is dead at this point because it's like the end of the day. I've been on my phone all day. My phone is fucking dead. So we get to this fucking gas station and I'm literally realizing like I'm in a bad situation right now. So I get out of the car at the gas station. I decide I need to use the phone. I need to call my friends. I need to figure out I'm gonna do because like this is escalated from like 0 to 100 and I'm genuinely scared for my life. Mind you, the sun is going down, so it's actually getting like super dark outside at the same time. So I go into this gas station and there's a long ass line. I'm crying genuinely because I'm concerned about my well-being, and this motherfucker proceeds to come in and assault me and drag me out back to the car as I'm literally screaming. No one in the gas station even batted an eye. No one helped me. Like, nobody even batted an eye.
Sis, these are some tips for you if you're getting flued out. My flued out days is over. I'm trying to really, like, build with somebody and all of that good stuff. But this don't got nothing to do with me. This got everything to do with y'all. First and foremost, you should never be getting flued out if you don't got no money. Don't fall into the trick of a man being like, oh, don't worry, I'll take care of you when you get here. You know, you don't got nothing to worry about. You should always be thinking like 10 steps ahead. Like, what if? And sadly, we don't want to like think the worst in somebody, but nowadays you have to.
If you made it this far, hit that like button and leave a comment to trigger YouTube's algorithm. I'm a new channel and I'm trying to grow. So hit that subscribe button and hit that bell to let you know every time I upload a new video.
Just like, so is this an assumed transaction? Fly me out, we spent some time together and I'm just obligated to give you the cootie cat. Like, somebody help me out.
I won't say it's obligated. I feel like if they are talking to the point where now y'all like, okay, I want to see, okay, woo, I'm gonna fly you out. And I'm pretty sure they've had these sexual conversations before. You know you gonna bust it open when you see him, like, or you know that was what, I'm gonna say you have to. And you were gonna do it. Now, whether you decide to do it last minute or not, I don't know, that's a different story. But I feel like women know when they're getting, you know,
like too far.
Yeah, and then it's like, you wasting his time for what though?
I just wasted your time. What you talking about? You got to be in my presence.
We're about to get you. We're about to get you, old Lulu. What do you say, baby? Don't waste his time.
You wasted his time.
If that's all that he's looking for, of course you're wasting his time.
Yeah.
But if that's all you're looking for, then don't fly me out.
But that's what I'm saying. It's based on the conversation they had before that. So they know if you're getting to that point where, okay, if I want to see you, I'm going to fly you out. Girl, you know you're going to end up probably having to give it to
him. It depends, though. Because people that, people that are flying you out, I would assume they have a certain financial status, and that's the reason that people that don't have that financial status be trying to do this fly out thing and getting upset. That's the problem. Is that your money is not long like that, so you offended when you have when you spend some money to fly somebody out because you don't usually spend money like that, which means you shouldn't be doing this anyway. You really shouldn't.
What if they are in the status of I got the bread, no matter like what, like no matter how
well,
much they got.
Well, like I said,
they still.
Okay, so
how do you spend $5,000 on a person that never gave you none? You know, and there's a lot of guys with money that think that if I just keep spending on a chick, you know, she gonna give me what I need. Most times that probably will be the case, but there are certain times where a woman that looking at a guy that's just giving her this paper is somebody that's just giving her paper. If you giving all of all this money without asking for anything in return, or you know, she's saying, yeah, I got you, but you keep feeding her, she looking at you as just a wallet at this point.
I've been in multiple long distance relationships and we saw each other within less than 30 days of like meeting each other, knowing each other, whatever, you know, from a distance.
Yeah.
And so that person just really wanted to see me. So I went to see them.
But did you smash?
No, I didn't.
Are you sure?
I'm sure.
But are you sure?
Like, am I sure? I'm sure. He didn't even stay with me.
There's something wrong with it.
He didn't even stay with me. He went to his house and I stayed on the
hotel. But would you? But would you have?
He won't. I dated him for like a year and a half after.
But would you have like the first time y'all?
I wanted to too, but I couldn't.
Well, that's
because I had to let it be known what I was here for, and I wasn't.
But you would.
I wouldn't be there if I didn't like it. I didn't want to.
And that's what I'm saying. But so if you get to that point of having that conversation,
if you
want to
have a relationship with him, then you cannot do that soon.
Okay. Man, we're too grown for that. I think it depends on who the guy is.
Because you can usually fill out who you're talking to.
That's what I'm
to.
Saying. If you get into that point and y'all talking already and you know this is what's probably going to happen, you're still going to want to smack or y'all going to have sex anyway.
The sister in the middle is the only one that's making a lot of sense. You understand what I'm saying? She's the only one that's making a lot of sense. You are a grown woman, and you know no man is going to fly you into a different city, spend money on you without expecting in return. Come on now. We're all grown. When you get on that plane, you already know once you land what that man is going to want from you. You know what the end result is.
I haven't been in that situation. I would just say all situations, it was really fast. And so there wasn't an expectation. Like, I only known you for 2 weeks.
Yeah.
I only known you for 3 weeks. There wasn't the expectation and they weren't offended.
So you want to know, I do see what your crazy ass saying. I see what you're saying.
If you're going to fly a woman out, don't be one of these losers making a video screaming, ranting and raving, being disrespectful, kicking her out of the hotel because she didn't want to sleep with you. First of all, that should have been established before she even got on the plane. Shorty, we've been talking for a few months. I like you. Come to my city, catch a vibe. But I want to do the no pants dance. Make your intentions known. And if she's not with it, don't even send your flight details. But if she does agree to that, she has every right to change her mind once she gets there. And a lot of the times, women change their mind because the dude is socially awkward, doesn't make her feel comfortable, overly aggressive when she gets there. And why would you want to broadcast your L to the world, showing the world that you're a loser and a non-closer?
Now, me personally speaking, I've had my shares of out-of-town cookies. One thing I always do, some people may agree, some people may disagree. One thing I always do, I make sure she flies herself in and she puts herself up in the hotel. When it comes to the dinner, when it comes to the entertainment, I got that. But you fly yourself in and you put yourself up in the hotel. That way, if we meet each other, if we're not vibing, it's cool. I can show you the town, get you some food, you get back on your flight, you go home. I'm not out here tricking. Everybody goes home, everybody respects each other. For me, that's how I've been doing it, and I've never been wrong. While you guys are out here flying women in, then getting mad and kicking them out, understand something. Once that woman gets on a flight coming to see you, if anything happens to her, you are the first person the cops are coming to talk to. Keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. So before you pay for any flight or book any hotel, gentlemen, make sure it's understood from the jump.
Like, if you know, if you're the type of girl and, okay, yeah, you enjoying the flights and the free food and the gifts and you know you're not sleeping, like, request to have your own room or you get your own room and you make it known before you get on the plane, like, yo, like, I do want to see you, I do want to hang out, but I want my own room.
Yeah, and it would be appropriate.
And whatever he respond to that, he gonna let you know, like, well, then right. You don't need to bring your ass.
Right.
And if you ladies cannot afford to pay for your own flight, pay for your own hotel room, and pay for your own rental car, now, my dear sister, you are not ready to date a man that lives out of town.
Y'all, I promise if y'all just help me get home this last time, I will never link to fuck another rapper for free. If y'all just get...
Now, what do you guys think? Do you agree or do you disagree? Either way, leave your comments below so we can start this conversation. Until the next video... Stay safe in the streets. Later. That will wrap it up for today's episode. And thank you for joining me. So please, leave a comment below. If you agree, if you disagree, it doesn't matter. Leave the comment below. And also, you tell me what you want me to cover. You tell me what you want me to discuss and what you want me to react to. Okay? And that's it, ladies and gentlemen. Thank you so much for joining me. And I see you on the next episode. Please don't forget to subscribe. Let's rebuild the black nuclear family. It is needed. Okay? God bless.